All of you are aware that this ongoing month of August has a lot of significance for all of us. And the reason is clear that we gained independence in this pious month. Children, in fact, all of you should be proud to be an Indian, as our Indian civilization is one of the most ancient civilizations in this world. It is creditable that despite the modernization and influence of West, we have managed to retain the main fabric of our national culture. India is spiritually evolved and sacred land where rishis and munis have meditated since ages. Our land has been full of ashrams and gurukuls where divine values and ideals were nurtured in young minds. India is a country which possesses divine wealth. It is a country where people from the economically rich countries of the West came to learn and evolve. They come to the Himalayas and to meet and seek guidance from the yogis to practice yoga and obtain our immense spiritual wealth, which has the tendency increasing through sharing. Only spiritual life can give real and everlasting peace and happiness. In words of late Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, from his book, Jab Paschim ne banphal khakar chhal pehenkar laaj bachai, tab Bharat se saam gaan ka swargik swar tha diya sunai. Agyani manav ko humne divy gyan ka daan diya tha. अंबर के लता ललाट को चूमा अतल सिंधु को छान लिया था. नाउ अ फ्यू थिंग्स टू पॉइंट आउट. सी द फर्स्ट पॉइंट व्हिच आई वांट टू टेल यू इज दैट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ब्लैक होल्स हैज बीन वेल डिस्कस्ड इन ऋग्वेदा अबाउट 10,000 इयर्स अगो व्हाइल इट वाज डिस्कवर्ड वेरी लेट बाय साइंटिस्ट ऑफ द वेस्ट. सिमिलरली यू विल बी अमेज्ड टू नो दैट इंडस वैली सील्स हैव सिंबल्स that resembles with those of modern day nuclear physics and astrophysics. This indicates that ancient Indians had a knowledge of cosmology and particle physics. Even the Rig Veda described sun's orbit and attractions of the planet 1000 years before Copernic deciphered it. And so the children, this list is endless. All of you should be proud to be an Indian today. The children of class 11D are here to remind you that how rich you all are in terms of culture and tradition. Let's devote few minutes today to rejoice on the glory of ancient India. Now over to Manija and Yashi to start with the proceedings. Jai Hind.
Thank you, ma'am, for sharing with us such knowledgeable information. Good morning, one and all. We students of class 11D shall be presenting today's assembly. The topic for our assembly is Lost Glory of India. I, Manija Bhola,
and I, Yashish Srivastav, shall be your host for the day.
India is a treasure trove of knowledge, wisdom, and heritage. From town planning to artistry, new discoveries to new inventions, astrologers to philosophers, the list of India's rich past goes on and on. So today, we would like to give you all a glimpse of India's past glory.
In India, there is a tradition to remember the Almighty before doing a good deed. Now, I would like to invite Siddharth and Vidisha to recite the morning prayer.
We shall join our hands, close our eyes, and get ready for the Gayatri Mantra. Om Bhurbhuva Swaha Tat Savitur Varenya Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodaya. Thank you.
We join our hands and close our eyes. Twameva mata cha pita twameva twameva bandhu cha sakha twameva twameva mitra dravidam twameva twameva sarvam mama deva deva ya kunde tuchar har dravila ya shubhra vastra vrita या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्मा सुत शंकर प्रभुतवे देवै सदा वंदिता सामा पातु सरस्वती भगवती निशेषाजा पहा हे प्रभु आनंद दाता ज्ञान हमको दीजिए, शीघ्र सारे सद्गुणों से पूर्ण हमको कीजिए, लीजिए हमको शरण में हम सदाचारी बने, ब्रह्मचारी धर्म रक्षक वीर व्रत धारी बने, असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा मृतं गमय ओम शांति शांति।
Yashi, do you know that out of the varied values of Indian culture, those based on spiritualism have contributed a lot, harnessing the spirits of Indians throughout the ages?
Is spiritualism inherited in our culture?
Yes, and you know, my friend Dipanch, who is currently reading the Bhagavad Gita, shares his views on spiritualism with me often. So now let's invite Dipanch to share his views with us.
Well said, Yashi and Manija. India is known in the entire world for her philosophy of spiritualism. Often people get confused and treat religion and spiritualism as synonyms. But on the contrary, these are two entirely different concepts. Thinking that the world was created by God is not an unscientific thought. There are skyscrapers built by architects and huge cranes built by engineers. So it is natural to think that the universe was created by someone. That someone is what we term as God. You know, Yashi, the world is now realizing the importance of Bhagavad Gita. Lots of scholars around the globe are trying to decipher the knowledge embedded in the 18 chapters of Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita is a direct extract from Lord Krishna. He tells us about how we should be living our lives. He says that we must believe in our karma or actions. No matter what work we are doing, we must do it with all our capacity and thought. We should not think about the result while taking action. The moment we start thinking about result, we are then not fully engrossed in taking actions. He also says about importance of meditation. Meditation helps us regulate our thought. In the end, it helps us connect with that higher intelligence, the intelligence which has been felt by yogis. In the end, I would like to say one thing. It's not the religion which we should pursue. We must pursue the spiritualism. Just think how amazing it is. See towards the sky away from phones. God, Allah, Krishna, Jesus, or merely higher intelligence. He made this world, the animals, the plants. He still made us because he thought that the world needs us. So our ancient scriptures wanted all of us to rise above the petty issues of the religion and attain the bliss of spiritualism.
I have read that yoga has been practiced since the Indus Valley civilization, and it is also mentioned in the Rig Veda and Upanishads. What do you know about yoga, Shambhavi?
In today's times, yoga has emerged as a great savior and saved a million of lives. I have seen many Americans and Britons practicing yoga in today's times. What do you have to say, Vani?
Look at the tragic part that the Western countries are adopting yoga as main style, while the new generations of Indians are attracted towards Zumba, aerobics, which deals only with the exercise of the physical body.
Yashi, do you know that India has been the birthland of so many mathematicians like Aryabhatta? And sadly, the only thing we know about Aryabhatta is that he invented zero. So Shreya, who is a math enthusiast, would like to share with us more about the contributions of Aryabhatta.
Aryabhatta to the world happened through his remarkable work in the field of mathematics and astronomy. Aryabhatta is one of the most renowned Indian mathematicians, in fact, one of the first. He has written many treatises in both mathematics and astronomy and was also known as the father of algebra. Many of his works were lost, but some are still available for the modern scholars and hold great credibility. His most notable work is Aryabhatiya and Arya Siddhanta, which were hugely influential texts and present many ideas that are foundation to modern astronomy and mathematics. He calculated the closest approximate value of pi till that time and was also known as the first person to solve Diophantine equation. He gave the concept of zero and the place value system. He made incredibly accurate calculations of the length of the day and the year as well as the circumference of the earth. He correctly explained how the moons and planets have no light of their own, but shine due to the reflection of sunlight. Furthermore, he corrected the flawed belief that eclipses are caused because of the shadows cast by the earth and the moon, and instead explained the correct causes of eclipses. Aryabhatta correctly insisted that the earth rotates about its axis daily and that the apparent movement of the stars is a relative motion caused by the rotation of the earth, contrary to the then prevailing view that the sky rotated. Solar and lunar eclipses were scientifically explained by Aryabhatta. He states that the moon and planets shine by reflected sunlight instead of prevailing cosmogony in which eclipses were caused by Rahu and Ketu. He explains eclipses in terms of shadows cast by falling on Earth. The contribution of a scientist since Aryabhatta has never been the same. He truly made the world notice India in terms of holding scientific knowledge and the value that actually made a difference to the world. He challenged and contradicted many beliefs that were going on at the time, and through calculation provided pieces of evidence for it to be true. And after all these years, his work does not flinch from meticulous accuracy. India recognizes his contributions, and the first Indian satellite to be sent to space was named after him as a tribute. He was the first in the classical age of India that excelled as a mathematician and an astronomer. At the time, without any advanced technology available, he was able to estimate and approximate his discoveries. We must take pride in his work as Indians.
Shushrut was an ancient Indian physician and surgeon, today known as the father of surgery and father of plastic surgery. But it is so sad that very few of us are now aware of our rich past. So I like to invite Shambhavi to share her knowledge on Shushrut with us.
Good morning to all. I'll be sharing a story about a person who became the reason of India being known as the Vishwaguru. So here it goes. Virechak's severed finger fell on the grass, staining it red. In sheer pain and horror, he pleaded with his friend to help him in any manner possible. His friend calmly lifted the finger and placed it on the stump. "Not possible," spoke Virechak, who now had it reattached with the help of a band-aid. 1 week of no disturbance and the finger was found in its place, functional and alive. In explanation, his friend only said, "Hamara sharir hi hamara chikitsak hai." Virechak's friend grew up to be Acharya Sushrut, the father of Indian surgery. The process he was talking about was simple mitosis. Using this principle, he went on to conceive and teach the very idea of surgery, and the world followed. When he couldn't find any dead bodies to practice, he practiced on stems and fruits. When he couldn't find the instruments to practice, he made them, observing the beaks, teeth, and claws of animals, which are used till date. Such was the dedication of a son of this land. Acharya Sushrut not only certified his caliber as a surgeon, but also proved India's caliber to be the teacher of the world, the Vishwaguru. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Shambhavi, for telling us so many things about Shushrut that we were not aware of. Do you know, Shambhavi, that we have a budding poet amongst us, and he writes amazing poems. Whenever Harsh writes a poem, he shares it with me. So now I like to invite Harsh to share a self-written poems with us.
Pure vishw ko karma sikhaya. Pure vishw ko karma sikhaya. Hum wo karmath gyani hai. Govardhan uthaya tha ungli par. Hum wo hathi abhimani hai. Vaksh faad kar dharma nibhaya. Hum wo karn mahadani hai. Jhule the jo faansi par. हम वो हठी अभिमानी हैं। ज्ञान विज्ञान को जन्म दिया, ज्ञान विज्ञान को जन्म दिया, गिनती हमने दिखलाई थी। विश्व को तारों की भाषा हमने ही सिखलाई थी। सुश्रुत के आशीष को हमने सर्जरी का नाम दिया। 20 सहस्त्राब्दी पहले ही शल्य चिकित्सा का वरदान दिया। आर्यभट्ट ने क्या बस जीरो का था निर्माण किया। कॉपरनिकस से पहले ही सूर्य का सिद्धांत दिया। माप बताया था परिधि का बताया काल जो गुप्त था। बोधायन ने बोध कराया वो पाइथागोरस का सूत्र था। भास्कराचार्य था वो जिसने गुरुत्वाकर्षण बताया था। न्यूटन से 800 वर्ष पूर्व ग्रहण का प्रमाण दिखाया था। जिसने परमाणु की खोज की वो महर्षि कणाद बड़े ज्ञानी थे। न्यूटन को गति दिखाई थी वे हठी अभिमानी थे। और बताऊं और सुनाऊं भारत की अमर कहानी को, ज्ञान विज्ञान के जनकों को, उन हठी अभिमानी को। पहला नोबल लाया था जो वो रमन हिंदुस्तानी था, परमाणु ऊर्जा को ऊर्जा देने वाला बोस हठी अभिमानी था, बसु और विश्वेश्वरिया थे रामानुजन सारा भाई, भास्करा और ब्रह्मगुप्त थे विज्ञान की परछाई, हम बाण भेद कर धरती से धारा निकाला करते हैं, हम बाण भेद कर धरती से धारा निकाला करते हैं, अपने स्वाभिमान के लिए अग्नि को गले लगाया करते हैं, फेंक कर पत्थर पानी में हम तैराया करते हैं, देश की रक्षा के लिए काल तक को झुकाया करते हैं, देश की रक्षा के लिए काल तक को झुकाया करते हैं। जय हिंद।
वाह हर्ष, मुझे नहीं पता था कि हमारे भारत का इतना स्वर्णिम इतिहास है और मुझे भारतीय होने पे पूरा गर्व है। धन्यवाद हमें ये कविता सुनाने के लिए।
We Indians practice a lot of traditions, but why do we practice them? Have you, Yashi, ever given it a thought?
Yes, Manita. You know that every Indian tradition has a logic behind it. Bunny is always curious to know scientific reasons and customs from ages.
Is that so, Yashi? Then we should invite Bunny to elaborate more on this topic.
Yes, Manija and Yashi, India is a mix of religions and cultures. We love that we experience so many different types of food, clothing, rituals, and praying to different gods. We have diversity in everything. There are certain traditions we've been following since we were kids. A lot of us have questioned these while growing up, and some of us have just followed them faithfully without any questions. Today, I've got some Indian traditions which have a scientific meaning behind them. Firstly, comes the Namaste. There is a scientific reason behind the Namaskar in the Hindu culture. Joining both hands ensures touching the tips of all the fingers together, which are linked to pressure points in the eyes, ears, and mind. Pressing them together is said to activate these, helping us to remember that person for a long time. The tradition of applying a tilak on the forehead during a puja is a famous one. This is because the point between both the eyebrows is considered to be the point of focus and concentration. This point is activated once the tilak is applied. Have you ever wondered why every house in the Indian household has a tulsi plant growing in its backyard? This is because tulsi helps in warding off evil and negativity. It has healing powers. The plant has medicinal properties and therefore it is used to fight common cold, cough and other diseases. Moreover, it helps in boosting the immune system. We have a tradition of paying our respects to the sun god early in the morning through the Surya Namaskar. Waking up to follow this routine ensures we are prone to a morning lifestyle. You must have worshipped Shivling this time in this monsoon. As the season transitioned from summers to winters during the monsoons, the levels of vata in our body rises. This is the reason why our ancient scriptures tell us to offer milk to Lord Shiva during the months of monsoons. During this season, the cattle eats many insects and bacteria along with the grass. So the milk supplied by these cattle are not fit for our consumption. Offering this venomous milk to Lord Shiva is just a way to protect ourselves from deadly diseases during the monsoons. Very interesting, right? I tried to cover up some common Indian traditions this time, which is just the tip of an iceberg. The list is endless. And in fact, I'm very proud to live in a country that has so much knowledge.
Now, we would like Romini ma'am to say a few words on how she feels to be an Indian.
Good morning, teachers and children. I am a very, very proud Indian and I cannot think of any other country beyond India. Today, you have validated my pride in my country. You spoke of scientists, you spoke of surgery, you spoke of astronomy, and Harsh summed up everything so beautifully in his poetry. And then you brought in these traditions which we follow, and you know that we basically are a spiritual country. So when we bind something to religion, more and more people tend to follow it. You know, these days, it's not about this a year or two, but for quite some time, there has been a large outflow of scientists, of professionals from our country, because they feel they learn more in countries outside India, and eventually they settle there and don't come back. So if all knowledge was outside this country and dependent on facilities which the Western countries give, we really have to ask a question, then how did that initial knowledge come to us? How did that knowledge come to Aryabhatta? How did it come to Sushrut? There were no facilities of this kind. So this tells us that all knowledge is within. If you sit with yourself and if you really focus on yourself and you go beyond the outer limit of physical body, then you will dig into that reservoir and you will invite such energies that you will not need to find too many resources outside the country for your growth and eventually the growth of this country. The difference between the scientists, I am not generalizing, but a large person of people, the present and the past ones, is that in the past, there were scientists who were spiritual. They were spiritual scientists. That is why you're saying Maharishi so and so. So they dug into the gyan that was within them. They could understand knowledge is within, but somewhere we have digressed from that aspect of ourselves because we first look at the outer world and then we imitate that outer world and you want to become like that outer world. The technique is that you first go into your inner world, find the knowledge there to expand and bring it to the outer world. So, you know, this is the essence of Jaipuria School's teaching philosophy. Children, this is the reason why we stress so much on spirituality and we do spiritual retreats and we talk about spirituality, which is, I'll not say above or below religion, but we have to understand it a little bit. So thank you so much. Immense gratitude for bringing out such a wide, wide assembly.
Thank you, ma'am, for your inspiring words. Now, I and Manija sign off as hosts. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.